Terror is on every side. Denounce him, let us denounce him, say all my familiar friends, watching for my fall. Perhaps you will be deceived, then we can overcome him and take our revenge on him. But the Lord is with me as a dread warrior. Therefore my persecutors will stumble. They will not overcome me. They will be greatly shamed, for they will not succeed. Their eternal dishonor will never be forgotten. O Lord of hosts, who triest the righteous, who seest the heart and the mind, let me see thy vengeance upon them, for to thee have I committed my cause. Sing to the Lord, praise the Lord, for he has delivered the life of the needy from the hand of evildoers. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
In your great love, answer me, O Lord. In your great whispered, proclaim upon the housetops. And do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul. Rather, fear him who can destroy both soul and body in hell. Are not two sparrows sold for a penny, and not one of them will fall to the ground without your Father's will? But even the hairs of your head are all numbered. Fear not. You are of more value than any sparrows. So everyone who acknowledges me before men, I will also acknowledge before my Father who is in heaven. But whoever denies me before men, I also will deny before my Father who is in heaven. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
One of the most gifted speakers in the history of the Church was St. John Chrysostom, and his name Chrysostom comes from the fact that he was such a great preacher. His Greek words that mean golden-tongued. So John the golden-tongued, such a great preacher. And St. John was sent from Antioch to what was then Constantinople, where he preached fearlessly in the capital of the Eastern Roman Empire. He denounced the lavish extravagances of the rich and the ruling classes, and his condemnation of that excess infuriated many, especially the condemnation of immoral living. And one of the people he upset was the Empress. And you don't really want to upset an empress. And so St. John Chrysostom was exiled. And when he was told of his fate, that he was going to be sent off into exile by the empress, St. John Chrysostom said this: "What can I fear? Will it be death? But you know that Christ is my life, and that I shall gain by death. Will it be exile? But the earth and all its fullness is the Lord's. Will it be the loss of wealth? But we brought nothing into the world and can carry nothing out. Thus all the terrors of this world are contemptible in my eyes, and I smile at all its good things. Poverty I do not fear, riches I do not sigh for, death I do not shrink from." Those extraordinary words of St. John Chrysostom resonate now throughout the ages, because they call each of us in our Christian life, in our Christian journey, to have no fear, to not be afraid. For far too many of us now, we're worried about what people think of us more than what God thinks of us. We can have a desire not to offend others, which of itself is commendable, but that's often elevated above everything else. We mustn't upset someone. We mustn't disturb them. But that is not how we preach the gospel. Because if we do that, then we shrink back from preaching the truth. Because we have to have that love of God that means we don't fear men. And that is at the heart of this Sunday's Gospel. Our Gospel this Sunday, our Lord tells us right from the start, have no fear of men. That's the command of the Lord for all of us in our Christian life. And yet, each of us in our lives can be paralyzed by fear. The fear of upsetting someone, the fear perhaps of being found out for the sinner that we are, the fear of being condemned by those around us, the fear of losing friends, the fear of being unloved by those that we love. That fear paralyzes us and stops us from being ourselves. It stops us from knowing the freedom that comes in Jesus Christ. Because he calls us to have no fear of men, but rather to fear him who can kill is natural. Today people sometimes think, well, why should we fear God? Surely God is love, we shouldn't fear God. Well, today around the world is Father's Day. So a happy Father's Day to all dads, to all those who look after children, who are guardians of children. Happy Father's Day to all of them. But today is Father's Day. Now, I love my dad, and I know that my dad loves me, but I would never mess with him. When I was a child, if my father said jump, I would say how high. Now, I'm much older, I wouldn't necessarily say how high, I'd say dad, I can't jump anymore, but at least that wouldn't go against him. Because as a child, as a son, there is a natural respect, there is an awe, there is a fear, if you like, of disappointing our parents, of disappointing our dad. That's the same fear that we should have of God. And that's what we mean when we talk about the fear of God. Not a fear of someone that we're scared of, but a fear of disappointing him. A fear of letting him down, because he's the one who loves us above all things. And because of that love, then we have that fear of him as well. Not a fear of men, because that paralyzes us, but a respect, an awe, a fear of God is what sets us free. Free to truly be the child of God that we were created to be. But free then to proclaim and live our gospel. The abounding rule of society today seems to be, don't upset anyone. Well, none of us has a right to not be upset. None of us has that right. We do have the right to believe and to proclaim what we believe. But nowhere really does it say that we have the right to not be upset. We should be upset by so many things in life. Upset about our own sins, upset about the state of the world, upset about what we see going on in the news. But if someone has an opinion, if someone has a voice that they want to raise, they should never be screamed at or shouted down. And all too often that's what we see in the world we live in today. Everybody has a voice, and everyone's voice deserves to be spoken. It doesn't necessarily deserve to be listened to, but it does deserve the freedom to be spoken. And that's important for the world we live in, because we need that freedom as Christians. To speak the gospel, to speak what we believe. It may be that people don't listen. One of the most terrifying phrases in all of Scripture is when in the gospel our Lord says that love in most men will grow cold. I think that's the most terrifying phrase in Scripture. And yet, it's a reality that we see around us all the time. But that's why today's gospel is so important in our own Christian life. That we should have no fear of men. We should have no fear of what people may say or what they may do. But remember the example of St. John Chrysostom all those centuries ago. He was a gifted speaker. He spoke and people wanted to listen until it became something they didn't want to hear. And for that, St. John Chrysostom was exiled. But he didn't treat exile with any fear. Remember that quote from him today. What can I fear? Will it be death? Will it be exile? Will it be loss of wealth? None of that he feared. Because he feared God. Because he loved God. And he knew that God loved him. So today, our gospel this Sunday. is a challenge for all of us in our Christian life. To be set free from fear, to not be paralyzed by fear, but instead to genuinely live and proclaim the saving gospel of Jesus Christ. Because we are precious in God's sight. And our gospel then leads on this Sunday to that truth. He says, are not two sparrows sold for a penny, and yet not one falls to the ground without our Father knowing it. He even knows the number of hairs on our head. Well, for some people that counting is easier than for others, but still, the Lord knows them. That's how important we are to God. Think of that. That God, who created everything that exists, God who created the sun and the moon and the stars, God who created the universe, God who created the air we breathe and the soil we stand on, God who created all these things, knows the hairs on your head. That's how precious you are to God. And that's why we should never fear men, but strive above all to live in the love of God, to be comforted by it, to not be paralyzed by worrying about what people will say of us, and instead worrying about disappointing God, because He is our loving Father. And on this Father's Day, thank God that we can call God Father, that we can cry out Abba, that we can cry to Him, and He will always hear us. So remember the example of St. John Chrysostom. He lived centuries ago, and yet that example is one that speaks throughout the centuries. May we all live up to that example. May we all be like him, and speak, and proclaim the wonder of God. Because that is our only hope.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten not made, consubstantial with the Father, through him all things are made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. And by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess my baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Dear brothers and sisters, Christ calls us to abandon our fear of men and place our trust in God, trusting that God always hears our prayer. Let us now pray for the Church, for the world, and for each other. We pray for Pope Francis, we pray for the whole Church of God. May the Lord take away all fear, so that we may boldly proclaim the same. gospel of Christ Jesus. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for vocations to the priesthood and religious life. We pray especially for vocations to our Norbertine community here in Chelmsford. May the Lord send good and holy men to work in this vineyard. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all those who still await their first Holy Communion and for those waiting for the sacrament of confirmation. May they be granted the graces they need to continue to wait patiently for those moments of God's grace and love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for all fathers on this Father's Day. We thank God for the blessings our parents have given us. May all parents model the example of Saint Joseph and truly be the first teachers of their children in the ways of faith and love. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those who are sick or suffering and in need of our prayer. May the love of God bring them comfort and strength. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We pray for those who have died, especially for John Hopgood, Annie Cohen, Jack Mansworth, Peter Cracknell, Bridie Ramshaw, Joseph O'Callaghan, John Canton, and Paul Wall. May the souls of all the faithful departed rest in peace and find everlasting joy in the arms of God. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
We bring all our prayers and needs to the loving heart of the Immaculate Mother of God as we say together,
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we ask you to graciously hear all our prayers, which we make in confidence, through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
unto a setting of your sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family, whom you have summoned with